swing the ox when I rumble, show your ass with my gundle. Got a temper, nigga, go ahead, lose your head. Turn your back on me, get clapped and lose your legs. I walk around, gun on my waist, chip on my shoulder top, bust a clip in your face, post it, this beef ain't over. The feds didn't know much when Pop got shot. I got a kite from the pins that told me Tuck got knocked. I ain't gon' spell it out for you motherfuckers all the time. Are you a literate nigga? You can't read between the lines. In the Bible it says, what goes around comes around. Homo shot me 3 weeks later, he got shot down. Now it's clear that I'm here for a real reason. Cause he got hit like I got hit, but he ain't fucking breathing.
Thank you. Alright, one more. Be right back.
Oh boy, how are you guys gonna get out of this now?
Uh-oh. All these hijinks.
Also, I thought Aku would be here for today's session, but he's not, so I guess we'll play this part when the time comes.
Yeah, the part?
It does. You all have a part in the grand story.
Interesting.
Texas tomorrow, and it's 107 degrees in Texas.
Texas?
What part of Texas are you going to?
San Antonio.
Damn, I was like, yo, if you stop by Houston, yeah, I could say hello.
That's only like, what, a 4-hour drive?
Yeah, dude, get some brisket? Fucking do it. I don't know why you wouldn't, really.
I'm gonna be there tomorrow, and then I will be back on Thursday. Trying to get out of your fucking accursed state as fast as possible, Oz.
Wait, what? Oh, yeah. Place is hot as hell.
That state is a fucking monument to man's hubris.
So, like, the difference what I noticed between Florida and Houston, like, they're both hot, but, like, Houston's humidity is just a tad bit worse. At least Houston. San Antonio is not as bad, but still, nonetheless. Both are hot
as
hell.
I mean, come to Miami, bro.
Oh, I've been to Miami.
Hot as fuck.
Yeah, it is hot as hell there, too. Especially because of how close you are to the coast. I don't know if you're still that close, though.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you think you know hot? Name every temperature.
Oh, God, not that shit. Fucking nice.
Are we all here? Is this it?
If
it's missing Yaku and Drektor, then yeah, right. It seems like everybody.
Oh shit, is Aku not making the session? Fuck.
Apparently not.
Session.
Ever.
Wait, what?
Talk about it later.
Oh, fuck. Okay.
I'm assuming it has to deal with his job.
Yeah. Damn.
Alright. Where is my music?
I don't actually have any additional information. I'm just assuming that since he got a job, you know.
That's what I'm assuming. He got off last time at 9:30, like an hour in.
Yeah.
There we go. Yeah, that's what I like to hear.
Yeah.
Well, you were asking questions earlier, Joe, as to what happened last session, and Easy will be more than happy to tell you what happened.
Tell me, Easy.
So we last left off at a coast of a corner, seems to be of a steep mountain, where we were talking to that person's name, which I have in my notes somewhere that I'm going to have to pull back up, because actually, are they a character in our thing? Yeah, Slatus Vidar. We zone of truth, Is it Pebbles? No.
Pebbles.
Yantha. We zone a truth Yantha because ultimately Matt got a little testy with Judge about saving her without actually, you know, finding out why were they have her flip upside down being fed to whatever that monstrosity was. And she would not tell us the answers we wanted. She kept shut. So pretty much she's holding a secret that she doesn't want to say. After removing the zone of truth, she was telling us a bunch of what we believe to be lies because she started talking after the zone of truth went down. After that, I think we slept. Correct me if I'm wrong there. But after we slept and we got up, apparently a wall behind us came undone. And we met Bishop, who was sent by Gazrim to escort us back to the hall of the Zentarin. So with Bishop leading us away, we pretty much got back into Mantle Daerith and we were escorted to the Zentarin stronghold where we met Gazrim. Oh, actually, before we passed by the Zentarin stronghold, we saw a bunch of Drow sitting at a table. They said a bunch of shit to us. We ignored them. We walked past them. And then we got to the Zentarin stronghold. We met Gazrim with his quote-unquote pet beholder, Lothurn. And he started talking
to us
about...
It was Sinny that called him a pet.
That's why I said quote-unquote pet. Quote-unquote. I was going to get to that part. So... Pretty much, he explained to us how the money is run by gold, and this is their ultimate achievement. And Sinny started gassing up the Zentarim, saying how they were the few folks who, I don't want to say kept to their word, but got us to here, to Mantle Daerith. Apparently, we were interrupting Gazrim in the meeting, so he says that the gnomes and the dark dwarves having a conflict is an interest of both him and the drow, and they were going to talk about it. So he walked to the table where the drow was. Grok noticed something that was sitting up there. He didn't really know what it was, but he felt the presence of it. And they started talking about business. He started talking about eliminating the dark dwarves out of the picture so that they would be able to have more control in Mantle Daerith when it comes to money. Dark elf buddy, Syrak, was not feeling it at first. Then after he wrote something on a piece of paper, he smiled and stood up and was going to say something, and then the dark elves around Syrath started attacking Lothurn. Apparently the gargoyle was in love that came down with Grok felt up there in the corner, was in love with one of the dark elves that was part of that party. Syrak quote unquote didn't know what was going on. Gazrim ran away while his beholder was getting beat up. Then after we took out some drow, Sinny slipped up and told Gazrim that he needs to go and, you know, help out his pet. Lothurn didn't really like that, so he blasted Sinny for some damage. Bishop held Syrak for a very long time where he stands now. And after we defeated all the drow except for one who was feared by the beholder, we are now there.
And the very first drow that essentially got up to begin the fight managed to...
Ran away because she was feared. Yeah, she was feared, so she kept running away. And she looked like she escaped.
So, yeah.
By the way, are we listening to music?
We are.
I did spare the dying one.
Oh, yeah, you did. By the looks of it, right there.
And I reduced size. Yeah, so I still have it for about like 50 seconds.
I'll try and medicine check the other guys that are laying around. There's clearly something weird going on.
Man, Cindy medicine check draws. Never see the day.
Hey.
Are you going to try to stabilize them, Cindy?
Yeah.
Okay, let's see.
I mean, like, you know, there's obviously something silly. I can't see what I rolled. Okay. It's okay. You want me to roll three of them?
No, 16. 16 is good. So you manage to bandage up the wounds from the three drow. And you end up, we'll say you end up stabilizing two of them, and one of them, their wounds were far too great for you to be able to stabilize. I'll put you over here so you can move around.
Okay. Can I try and stabilize Big Boy too? I don't know if he can, like, how he works with being stabilized.
Big Boy vanished, no? He just vanishes.
Yeah.
Does he automatically get unsummoned when he dies? I don't know if we ever...
I thought that's what happens. I thought, like, he crumbles to the ground, and then, like, he just, like, vanishes.
Really quick, yeah. I don't see anything. I can see the map, but there's fog of war over where we were fighting by the table with the drow.
You might have to reload.
Yeah. Let's try that.
Yeah, let me make sure your icon is saved to Kelly.
Still fog of war.
Do you see the table?
I see the table. I see. Do I just click on my character? Save configuration. It moved me like I should be able to see things, but I just don't see anything because of the fog.
You step all your brain juice, scrying me.
Hold on, let me look at the character sheet for you. Oh, hold on.
Oh god, this is why you can't see anything.
There we go.
Oh fuck.
Can you see now?
Yep.
Okay, it's because I changed your name.
Oh, okay.
This is a little too...
I'll, while Cinny's kind of mending them, I'll be like, with the little guy right here in front of me, I'll be like, well, little one, speak up, or, I don't know, maybe Cinny over here will want to kill you?
I don't know if I want to kill him quite yet. I definitely want to know what the hell they were thinking.
They don't know that. They don't
know that. Attacking a very respectable and powerful beholder. For no reason, as far as we can tell. I brush like soot off my fucking cloak because I got special beam cannoned.
Mr. Beholder, by chance, do you what do you like to eat?
Lorthun looks around and says, "Human, drow, halfling." Gnome.
Oh, okay. Just making sure. And as I inch this little version of this guy towards the beholder, I'm like, oh, I guess you might be hungry if this man doesn't want to speak up.
You can roll an intimidation with advantage on that guy.
Alright.
Damn! What a fucking scary little guy. Look at you.
What are you trying to get out of them?
More or less why they attacked Gazrim so quickly, I guess you could say, when he just arrived.
Okay, so the drow actually attacked Lorthun. Gazrim was in the way. They went after the beholder.
That makes more sense. It just, from my point of view, it looked like that.
Yeah, so, okay, and then if that's the case, you ask that, and that's a drow replies and says, we were hired to kill the beholder, not Gazrim.
Oh, I see. Well, looks like the beholder is hungry, so as I just inch him towards him, and then I'll take a step back and continue eating some of this food off the table that hasn't been touched.
Who paid you to do this, or hired you to do this?
The drow is going to hesitate for a moment, and then clearly, very visibly, fearful, is going to say, it was Kinyel.
is Kinyel?
Kinyel, the drow describes Kinyel as the...
Yeah, didn't that guy yell Kinyel?
Oh, God.
As the other drow that that sprung the attack.
No, Kinyel was the first one that attacked. The Gargro was screaming.
Kinyel, my love!
That's correct.
I wonder if that's what happens to people. They turn to gargoyles when they are infatuated by women too long. As I look at Scudge.
Well, you better point your beady little eyes elsewhere.
Ooh, alrighty. As I do those quick eye darts away.
So as you guys are interrogating him, Cyrak, who is still being held right now, he's gonna notice that everyone's weapons are essentially being put at the
Whoa, whose weapons being put down here?
Well, you're no longer fighting. And now you guys are talking. Okay. Clearly the tension has dropped in some capacity. So Cyrak is gonna see
this
that.
Is a fucking drow.
As combat has ended, and he's going to say, unhand me at once, you tin can. And he's going to say that towards Bishop, clearly aware that Bishop is the one casting a hold person on him.
I'll end the cast.
Okay. As soon as you do, you notice that he regains control over his shoulders and his arms, and he's going to brush his clothing off a little bit. He's going to then walk up, and he's going to walk right past you guys, and he's going to go towards Lorthum and Gosrim, and he's going to yell and say, Gosrim, did you have anything to do with this? And Gosrim is going to, look left and right and see the drow and everyone, and he's going to say, Cyrak, do you really think that I would be so risky as to cause a second war in such a profitable venture such as Mental Dareth at this particular point in time? Come now, Cyrak. And when he says that, Cyrak looks left and right, and he's gritting his teeth, and he seems frustrated, and he says that
Can I roll insight?
Sure.
Let's see if he's fucking being a silly willy or not.
15. You think that Gosrim is telling the truth right now? That he actually doesn't know, but you get the impression that he seems to have a silver tongue. It's just in this particular facet, you think that what he's saying sounds pretty truthful.
Okay.
Well, Judge is gonna pipe in and say, well, it seems that there was an underhanded deal amongst your folks. I'm going to look at Cyrak. Clearly, this seems like a misunderstanding. The main focus should be is why are they after Lorthun?
Cyrak looks at the beholder and kind of disinterested in what Judge is saying. Steps forward, he steps across the group, and he moves over towards the drow that are laying there bandaged up, and in a incredibly quick feat, to the point where you almost don't catch it, he walks by, and as he walks by, he slits the throat of both the drow as he walks by to the last one.
Dude, and, those are my last bandages.
He looks at the final drow that's reduced and looks up at the beholder and says, fine, you may eat him if you truly wish. Consider it as an apology on behalf of the drow for this this embarrassing moment.
I'm going to whisper to Matovu that, man, this town is wild.
So Cyrax says that, the reduced drow is shaking in his boots and saying, no, please, it was just, and as soon as he's about to finish it, the drow essentially levitates out, and Lord Doom takes a giant bite and swallows him whole.
No, please, no!
Wait, right. So what can you tell us about Kinyel? I'll ask Cyrax.
Cyrax says, I have no idea who that is. Ooh, as far as I was aware, that was just one of the members of the guard for the drow here in Mantle Dareth.
Can I roll insight?
Sure. He seems like after all of this, like he's telling the truth. He actually does not know that specific name. Yeah, so he's gonna say he doesn't know that specific name, and as soon as he says that, Gosrim is gonna like step forward to the group and say, Kinyel, I swear I've heard that name before. Well, if we had our other hostages or witnesses, we probably could have asked them exactly who that Kinyel was. But as it stands right now, I don't believe we could get any more information now, can we, Cyrak?
I'll look to Bishop. I was like, I'll say, you were the one that scryed me, right? Why don't we try and scry her and find out where she is? Get some answers.
I mean, she's across the river.
Yeah, she's...
Can we see her?
Well, she's basically like... Okay, well, at this point, after all this discussion, she would essentially be like moving back, trying to get into the encampment of the drow. She's like... This is like a very quick 2-3 minute conversation that's taking place as she's trying to beeline it back to the drow warehouse.
She pretty much is like here.
Oh, okay. Well, then fuck it. Let's go get her then.
Yeah. All right. I mean, don't we have, like, something of her possession?
So, Cyrek is going to... So, would you say that, Grook, that she's, like, on her way to the drow warehouse?
Say that last I saw her, she was across the river heading north to what looks to be your compound. And I'll point to Cyrak when I say that.
So Cyrak is basically just going to ignore the rest of the group, and he's just going to make like a run for the drow warehouse.
Well, let's follow him.
Wow, full sprint.
I'm going to try to jump across the water.
God damn it. I should have just not made. You can just run on the water.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Oh, do we have to go all the way around though?
Yeah, if you can go around, that'd be easiest. So Cyrek is going to arrive near the drow warehouse right as Kinyel is essentially like at the gate trying to get back in, and he's going to yell at the guards, and he's gonna say, halt! Do not let this traitor in! And Kinyel is, like, gonna turn around really quick. And, Cyrek is gonna take a couple steps forward and, say, guards, arrest her. So the two guards, like, position themselves to look towards Kinyel, and she's gonna look left and right. And she's going to swing wildly at Cyrak, and then almost instantly, both the drow apprehend her and tie her up.
It's with the fucking Oliver Twist kid over here.
You want to adopt the little drow boy?
Dude, it's like,
are they born evil?
No, he's fucking bumming me out. I want him to fucking go away.
Did you say that out loud? No. You do notice
that over there is what seems to be a very scared deep gnome, like, hiding behind
the rock. Oh, is it a deep gnome? Oh, fuck. Hold on. It's a deep gnome. I thought it was a crab. I'm going to, like, slowly approach him then and ask him what's wrong.
Okay. So,
I don't know. If he's young, he probably doesn't even know what Blinged Stone is, right?
Yeah, he's young. He's not like a kid, but he is definitely younger.
Okay.
Yeah, he's probably, he's like in the awkward, just becoming a young adult stage in his life.
Okay, I'm gonna...
His voice is a little crackly, you know, as he's trying to talk. He's a little bit on the squeakier end.
I'm gonna...
And he's gonna, like,
Like, as I approach him, then I'm gonna, like, kind of, like, we got, like an emblem when we left Blingdenstone, didn't we?
Yep.
Yeah, so I'm gonna kind of, like, make sure that he can see it so he knows that I'm not trying to come, like, hurt him.
Okay, he's gonna see the emblem, and he's gonna notice that, and he's gonna say, I haven't seen you guys here. What are you guys doing in Metaldareth? More surface dwellers, huh? You guys with the Zentarum?
That's a kind of a loaded question, but we're just here for some quick business, in theory. But what are you doing over here? Why aren't you over with the other deep gnomes?
He's going to stammer for a sec, and he's gonna say, that's a loaded question.
That's fair. Do you need some help? I mean, you look kind of, you don't look weak, but you look a little unassuming, like you could maybe use a hand.
He's like gonna look up at one of the, like, he's gonna like just look up, and he's gonna very quietly just point at the gargoyles up top, and without saying anything, and he's gonna say, they have it.
Have what?
They have. I fell, and one of them grabbed.
I'm gonna kind of lead him in, like, the gem. I'm gonna whisper it to him.
His eyes are gonna grow, like, really wide when you say that, and he's gonna, like, nod quickly and say, do you have it? Did you find it? Oh, Yanto's gonna be so pleased.
We don't have it, but I think we might be on the right track. Do you want to come along with us? See if we can get you in here. Do you know who has it specifically?
He's going to, like, look around and say that one of them snatched it from me.
Okay, here. Come with me. We're gonna get this whole nonsense sorted out. I'm tired of this fucking wild goose chase of fucking who's got the gym hot potato.
Flink is going to say aloud, by the way, I'm Flink. Hold on. Did I reveal this guy to you guys yet?
No.
I'll tell him.
You may have revealed him when you were revealing the other dude, and you did this whole dialogue that we were supposed to retcon.
Yeah, that's right. Well, here, we'll do this so you guys can see what he looks like. And he's gonna say, by the way, I'm Flink Thunderbonk.
Thunderbonk. Dude, I would fucking die for this kid. I'll tell him that I'm Cindy, and I'm with a group called the Abyss Watchers. We're on a mission here in Metaldareth, and I could probably convince him to let you tag along if you've been in direct contact with that gem. We're really trying to figure out what's going on with this situation right now.
He's gonna nod and not say anything more, and he's just gonna, like, follow closely behind you.
I'm gonna look at him, like, optimistic, but kind of realistic. Can you fight?
He's gonna, like, look down at his, like, he's arms like a scrawny, and his tattered clothes. And
I imagine this kid, like, homeless. He's got rags on. Hasn't eaten in like 10 days.
I'm gonna give him my dagger, and I'm gonna give him some of my food.
Wow. So he's gonna grab the dagger with a confused look on his face, and he's gonna say that I'm just an apprentice prospector working with Yantha. I don't know really how to hold a weapon.
I'll look at him, and it's like, well, when they have you pinned down to the ground and all you can see is their throat, I think you'll figure it out. You seem pretty smart.
He's going to slowly nod and hold the dagger awkwardly in his hand.
Well, hopefully you don't need that, but I wouldn't want to go through all this trouble of helping you for you to something to happen to you just because you were unarmed.
So he's going to nod. So while all of that is going on over here, the whole situation is unfolding with Cyrak and Kinyel. And as Cinny is up there in the back talking with Flink, Cyrak says, you know, apprehend her. She swings wildly her weaponry, and the drow end up knocking the weapons out, tying her up. And then Cyrak is going to look at her and say, do you realize what you could have cost the drow enclave here in Mental Dareth, you fool? And Kinyel is gonna reply back and say that there was no other way I could bring honor back to my house. And then Cyrak is gonna like spit on her like shoes and say that you fool, your house will hear the end. Your house will hear what you've done here.
I'm gonna.
What language is this in?
This is definitely in Drowish, actually. This wouldn't even be an undercommon.
Okay. It's good. That's
so, who here is Gruk? Are you the only one that understands that?
I think so.
Is it really obvious if I use, wait, comprehend languages? Does that work only for written?
Look it up. I'm not sure.
Any language you hear? As, like, he's kind of shaking her down, I'm going to look to Flink, and I'm going to ask him if that's who stole the gem from him.
Flink's going to look at...
yeah, you should be able to understand from that description.
Yeah, Flink's going to look at the drow, and he's going to shake his head, and he's going to point at the gargoyles perched up, and he's going to say, it was one of them.
I wonder if it was fucking Silly Boy. I don't know, I can't understand what they're saying, but I'm going to try and, like, read the situation. I'm going to yell at him to search her for the gem.
So, are you going to yell that in Undercommon?
Yeah, I'm going to yell it to the drow leader. I was like, hold on, I have an idea, search her for the gem.
Cyrak is going to turn around, and he's going to say,
what gem?
Search her for, just trust me. I don't have enough time to explain right now.
So you're going to see like a very confused look on his face, and he's going to look at the guards and he's going to say,
I mean, you're going to see a confused
face. Well, search her for
face.
The gem. So the two guards are going to go and they're going to search her, and out from one of her pouches, despite her constant like wiggling, one of the guards pulls out an enormous black gem from the inside of the pouch of Kinyel.
I'm gonna yell at him. Drop it. Drop it right now. I don't want you to not have it. I just think that there's something weird about that fucking gem.
So, do I have? I had a fucking picture of this.
Something weird about that. You can have it. Just let's figure it out.
Yeah, I'm like fucking. I've been playing fucking hot potato with this fucking thing all since we've gotten to this town. Fucking put it on the ground. Put it on the fucking ground.
Nobody move.
Give me one sec. I have a fucking picture of what this gem looked like. Give me one sec.
I swear to God, if it looks like the obelisk.
I'm gonna look down to Blink and I'll be like, results typically aren't that fast, but we're in the right place at the right time.
Results vary.
One sec. Ah, here it is.
Oh.
So this it is a enormous like obsidian black gem. Ooh. That as soon as you guys look, it looks like it's or as soon as it's pulled out, it looks like it's basically like absorbing light around it. It's so deep, dark, and black. It's the size of like a melon, essentially, as it's being held. It's enormous in the hand. And
it's just casually in her pocket.
It was in her pouch, in one of her like knapsacks.
That is the evilest thing I have ever seen. I don't even need to inspect it.
So as you tell that guard to like drop it, the guard is just gonna like hold it in his hands, and he's just gonna like kind of stare into it.
Oh god.
And Cyrak is gonna see this, and he's going to say ahem, and put his hand out. And Cyrak, the
no.
The guard.
What did you say about don't touch it?
He's gonna like look at you, City, as you say that, and then he's gonna say, what do you know about this gem?
I don't know shit about that gem, but I know that this town is being fucking loopy, fucking weird everywhere we go, and everywhere we go, we hear about that gem. Do not touch it.
It's being loopy?
So he's going to let's see a persuasion check, Cindy.
God. Zero charisma. Oh! Boom!
Wow!
Drop that shit off the ground.
That's pretty good.
Wow.
That's really good, yeah. Well, Cyrak is going to hear this, and then he's going to look at the, he's going to look at Kinyel, and he's going to look at his guard, and he's going to say, where did you obtain this, Kinyel? He's going to say this in Drowish. And Kinyel is going to, like, look up at Cyrak and pretty much in a defeated state, Kinyel is going to say, in Drowish, it was given to me. And Cyrak is going to say, given to you by whom? And then Kinyel is going to, like, cast a gaze to the side and say, an admirer. And Cyrak is going to, like, look confused at Kinyel.
I will approach when she says that, and I'll speak to Cyrak directly and be like, it was probably the gargoyle that was chasing her.
I'm going to, like, as I'm going to start moving forward, I'm going to motion to Flink to follow behind me.
Okay.
Like, I don't mean to be an outsider telling you guys how to run your business, but we need somebody that understands magic to look at that thing carefully before we do anything else. As our whole last, like, 2 years of our lives have been stupid demon crap. And I'm over it.
I've been stupid demon crap.
And he's over it, yeah.
So, Cyrak ponders this for a moment. And then says that, well, quite frankly, the person most capable to ascertain the true purpose of this gem would likely be Antha of the Deep Gnomes.
No. She already tried.
Oh, and he's going to look at you, Sydney, and he's going to look at the entire group and say, you lot know a curious amount of this gem, and you give off a aura that you know more than you lead on. What exactly do you know?
I know that it was stolen from the dwarfs, from the deep, and then, so I don't know what happened from there. Apparently a gargoyle had it, and then one of these drow have it, and everything has just been weird since we got into town. That gem is not good.
Pretty much that gem has been passed from hand to hand ever since we got into this town.
You can cast detect thoughts on me. You can open a zone of truth. I got nothing to hide.
So I'll kind of back up Sin and be like, since we've entered this town, we've learned that gem has been passed hand to hand through pretty much every faction in this place. First it started with the dwarves, then the deep gnomes got it, then the deep gnomes said the drow were giving it, and now we see that Yantha is holding on to it. So
you mean Kinyel?
Judge is
Kinyel,
gonna say,
excuse me, yeah Kinyel, excuse
same
me.
Same thing.
And Judge is gonna say, since you guys can't behave, we're here to set order to things. So Matthew Dareth can go
fuck
back
it.
To
fuck Grok is gonna face palm at this comment.
Oh boy.
Is it just
minus 15 rep of the drow.
Face palm.
It's not the time for water cowboy.
So at that comment, Cyrax says, is that so? Well then, consider the matter closed. The drow will be more than capable of dealing with this matter internally. Guards, guards, take Kinyel inside. And then he's going to turn around and Cyrax is going to say, we'll figure out what to do with the gem. Thank you.
Enjoy having your entire society fall apart. Bye.
So at that, the guards will open the door.
I'm going to, like, crack my quarterstaff on the ground. Be like, son of a bitch!
What, does he not? He wants... Maybe... What's the problem, Cinny?
You seem a little angry.
I am angry. The gem was right fucking there.
Who's your little friend here? As I point towards Flint.
So, yeah, Flink is gonna, like, step up, or he's gonna, like, peer to the side and say that, that was the gem. That's the one that Yatha's looking for. That's the one that I lost.
Talk to him, I'll be like, Yatha already had it, buddy. She's acting really weird. I think that gem is no...
Look at the bright side, Cinny. Now we can return back to the dwarves and tell them the drows have it.
Flink, you say, oh, go ahead.
It's like, we need to go back to Gazrim. There's gonna be a fucking shitstorm here pretty soon, and I think that it would be to our advantage.
I think he's probably going to enjoy it, to be honest.
I think we're gonna be on the up and up of this, because he seems to be the only leader around here that hasn't been affected somehow by that gem, other than I'm gonna look around really quietly as his thing getting attacked.
You can call it his companion, Cinny.
All I know is that Flink was taking care of it, and he told me a gargoyle stole it, so I mean, we're finding the connections. That gargoyle obviously...
So, how did the gargoyle steal it, Flink?
Flink is gonna, like, look to the side sheepishly and say that, well, Yanta and one of the dwarves were getting into a fight over it, and a lot happened. It was just really heated, and I knew that she really wanted the gem, so I took it and I ran. I didn't want him to take it because I saw how much she wanted the gem.
Okay, and what happened after that?
Flink's gonna say that, I tried to run and hide because the dwarves were just so mad that Yanta wouldn't give the gem back. And I tripped and I fell, and one of the gargoyles came down and grabbed it.
I'm gonna incite that. Oh, I believe him.
You believe him?
I'm going to look at him. I was like, this is really important, Flink. Did you touch it?
He's going to nod his head and say that there was no other way I could get it out of the warehouse.
I'm going to look at Judge. I was like, can you check him out? Make sure he's okay.
I'll probe his thoughts.
Well, now, just because...
It's a little personal.
Yes, just because, you know, he knows Yantha, be a little careful with him, okay?
So,
I'm gonna look to Mac and say, one of these days you're gonna meet a girl that's gonna make everything all better.
You'll hear me mumble, like, and be like, I already have.
Your heart will be unbroken.
That will never cease. Will always be broken from her. The fear,
so,
anyways,
are you just like openly casting detect thoughts on him?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So when you approach him, he's going to like recoil and step back like a little bit, and he's going to be like, "Whoa! What gives?"
Buddy, you touched that gem, and I'm going to kind of put my hand behind, like a firm hand behind his back, and be like, "You touched the gem." Which means you were probably acting just as weird as that drow was to her kin. We gotta make sure that you are not messed up in the head from the gem.
Yeah, we're just gonna check you out and see if you're, you know, something going on that you might not be fully aware of. We got no reason to.
I mean, you could have thought you tripped and fell, but for all we know, you could have walked over and handed it to the gargoyle without knowing.
All right, so. Okay, so emotions you get. You know that he seems pretty scared right now. He seems worried. He's very anxious. He feels kind of like, he's kind of surprised, not taking too kindly to the tech thoughts of it. But that's all that you can gauge from that. Do you wish to probe further?
Yes.
Oh, God.
All right, he is going to try to save.
Uh-oh.
And he fails. He is worried that if Yantha doesn't get the gem back, then Yantha will never love him.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. Fucking, oh, just a fucking simp gem, what the hell?
I have bad news. Your friend's a dweeb.
God, fucking, I know.
Do you tell us this or no?
Tell the group. I have no.
I mean,
I have nothing,
do you tell us this in front of him? That's nothing. The thing, though. Are you gonna say this in front of him?
Yes.
Oh wow, you're cruel, bro.
You're
fucking cruel, bro.
I'm gonna look outside. Ready for? He better have thick skin.
I'm gonna look to Flink and be like, "Do you mind if one of these guys tries to remove a curse from you, just to see if something's wrong?"
Like, looks around and he's like, sure?
Okay.
I'm gonna pull up my pipe and just start heavily smoking right now.
Okay.
You can do it, can't you, Titch?
Yeah. Okay. Alright, you want me to remove? Okay.
Will you be able to, like, can you tell if you, like, try and remove a curse and there's nothing there?
Mm-hmm.
Nah. Okay. Oh, you can? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Alright. Is there any way to tell this besides, can I do like a Morgana check or something?
About what?
See if he has a curse on him. Just how, I forgot, I think what's his name? Trektor does a medicine?
Yeah, he tries to do a medicine check and I pretty much needs the natural 20 yet, but you can try it if you want. You can try a medicine check.
I'll assist.
Ooh.
Oh, I was gonna give you advantage. I didn't. I can just roll since you already rolled. Boop. Bam, boop. Oh.
All right, fine. I'll remove curse.
All right. You know that he is not currently cursed.
Okay, great. Not cursed, City.
Damn it! What the hell is going on? I don't.
What's going on is we're going to tell the dwarves that we have proof that the drow has the gem.
I think we should approach Gazrim first before we go back to the drow. They're not going to like us when we approach their doors after we just have to fight them.
I'm going to look to Flink and be like, here, come with us. It's not safe to be walking around the town right now.
He's going to like look around and say, okay.
Fucking puber present boy. Oh, okay.
I'm gonna toss him down my bottle of torch chamber and tell him to chill out a little bit.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
He's not. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Are we in fucking prohibition right now?
No, no. Joe's right. He's a minor. He's only like 230 years old.
Yeah. Like fucking 200 years older than me.
You know, listen, that's minor years in Gnome, okay? They don't see the women's flesh until at least 200.
210 to drink.
They don't get to see women's flesh till at least 200 years old.
I mean, like, well, we can just... We'll ask Jim Jar next time we see him. I'm sure it's fine.
All right, so... So you guys approach these Antarim gates?
Yep. Gonna knock. Hey, we're here to see Gazrim. We just helped him. He probably knows us.
You're not gonna
help him
reply.
Not get killed.
No,
I'm gonna look to Bishop. Can you do your thing?
I bang on the door and I say, "Open up,"
and the gates open.
This what a password!
Baloney. It's fucking baloney.
Like fucking. What's your password? Password back.
I'm gonna look at these guards and be like, "Really? Oh, no. Can't just open up?"
The door does end up closing behind you guys.
Oh, wow. Look at this amazing and attractive beholder in front of me.
I am. What beautiful eyes you have.
Mount Hobu bows his head slightly.
Let's approach Mr. Gazrim here.
Lorthun is going to notice. He's going to take note of that. And then you're going to notice that he gives you one giant wink. Which actually kind of looks like he's just blinking at you.
Blink at you. Is, what's his name coming with us? Or is, Flink?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's right.
I just wanted to make sure that you didn't get, like, well, there, short stuff. What are you doing?
No, he's here. If you guys are with Bishop, you guys aren't getting any second glances from anyone.
Okay. All right. I'll approach Gazrim.
So, let's approach Gazrim and be like, alright, Gazrim. Seems like you like coin, and you like causing some ruckus to get more coin. The drow have a gem that the dwarves want. That's the whole reason why this whole thing happened, this whole outbreak with us, and the deep gnomes, and the dwarves. The dwarves know that the deep gnomes had it, and the deep gnomes were telling them that the drow have it. So now, if you approach the dwarves and tell them that the drow actually have it, you pretty much have a 3-to-1 side. 3-1 side here in Mantle Dareth against the drow. And I personally like fucking over the drow.
We have leverage.
So Gazrim is gonna like look around and he's gonna kind of like shake his head a little and say, explain to me what your plan is exactly. Do you believe that the Zentarim, the Dwergar, and the deep gnomes, two of which who have just been busy killing each other, are now going to unite under the same banner to attack the most powerful faction in Mantle Dareth?
I mean,
we have to do is bring proof that what the Dwergar gem, which the dark gnomes were telling, was the truth. I mean, wouldn't proof be able to set those aside for the greater of coin, or the greater good for both coin here? What's the problem.
We're acting as the muscle, not the brain.
So that was technically a lie to Gazrim, because the deep gnomes, according to what you've been told right now, the deep gnomes did take the gem.
Right, but she kept telling him that the drow have it. So if we were to approach the drow, approach to the dwarves as another faction and say, hey, by the way, we noticed that the drow have this gem, therefore clarifying that to the dwarves who were interrogating her that she was telling the truth, then...
Well, she said that the drow were hatching a big plan, and the big plan
I could have sworn she says that the drows have it. When she was hanging upside down, she goes, no, the drow have it. The drow made me give it to them.
No, she said the drow stole it.
Oh.
Yeah. That was okay, when you guys were asking her directly, and she wouldn't answer that in the zone of truth.
Because if she said to the dwarves that the drow stole it, that's still kind of the same thing, no? That pretty much the drow have it in their possession, and if another faction approaches a Dwargar and be like, hey, we noticed that the drow have a big black obsidian crystal. We heard that that's yours. Would that not classify them? They'd be like, oh shit, well, the gnomes were telling the truth.
Well, yeah, you could try it. You could absolutely try that. I'm just letting you know that the actual things, what you guys have been told, are not what you're telling Gazrim right now. So,
okay.
It needs to be... Yeah, so if you do, if you say that, that's going to be deception, because that's technically not the truth on what happened. Because she, Yantha specifically said that this whole thing was a big plan by the Drow to steal the gem.
Oh, I wrote something different down then. I could have, okay.
I'm gonna speak to him. I'm gonna say, well, what do you think is the best course of action? We've got all the factions at each other's throats, right? You seemed like you wanted to have a takeover, hostile or otherwise, of Mantle Dareth.
So, Gosrim is going to, he's gonna scratch his chin for a sec, and then he's going to sit down in a chair. He's gonna kick back his, legs, put his hands behind his head, and say, quite frankly, I think I should just relax and let the other factions off themselves.
Alright, cool. So let's talk about what's that grim place called that we need to go to? Blah, 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 blah. Where's my notes about that?
Graven Hollow.
Graven Hollow. So yeah, tell us about Graven Hollow then, if you just want to chill out here.
So he, like, you see a confused look on his face, and he said, I'm sorry, what?
We were told you know about Graven Hollow. That's what we were told. That's the whole reason why we're here.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Gruk is going to be like super like frustrated, man. He's just going to walk away screaming in Orcish.
I'm going to look to Gazer. He's just sneezing. He's okay.
According to Doc, somebody here should be able to help us with a ways to get to Graven Hollow. That was our deal.
So Gosrim laughs and says, yes, Dalvar tends to overpromise and underdeliver from time to time now, doesn't she?
Well, it's a shame because, you know, that's going to be a lot of, you know, treasure if she breaks our deal. I mean,
yeah, we were supposed to give her, you know, 10% of what we were getting.
But she doesn't want it. She doesn't want it.
Yeah.
It'll go to somebody else, the next, you know, highest bidder.
It sucks for her.
So Gosrim's going to shrug his shoulders and say, well, it's really her loss if that ends up being the case. And then he's going to say, now, however, if there were somebody in Mantle Dareth that happened to have some sort of idea on where to go, wherever this mystical place you seem to be calling, surely this would be a incredibly valuable piece of information.
I've got fucking roll inside all of this fucking guy. He's fucking being a shitter. can I have advantage from my knowing that he's got a silver tongue from earlier? I mean, I know he has the potential to be full of shit.
You can have somebody assist you.
Okay. Do you want to roll or do advantage?
I'll roll.
Okay. Ha! Liar, liar, pants on fire. Oh,
boy. So, Judge and Cindy, you both can gauge, based on how he's talking, that he probably knows about this location, and he is not being entirely truthful in what he's saying.
I'm going to look at him and be like, listen, I know that you're the big boss dog around here and must control the spice, blah, 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 but we are willing to work with you, but, you know, how about we just do whatever you tell us, and we'll give you Davra's portion. It was 10% of everything we've gotten so far, so if you tell us, I mean, I'll look over at, like, the soccer ball-sized bag of money Judge has for her.
So Gosrim is gonna, he's gonna wipe his brow a little bit, you know, like, fix
fucking
his eyebrow.
Sweaty frog.
Just fix his eyebrow to compose himself a little, and then he says, exactly how much would that be right now?
I don't know, I hit stuff. I don't mind the banks.
That's some valuable information. I don't know if I could just give it out for free.
Yeah.
Gosrim's gonna shrug his shoulders and say, very well then. you're free to use the Zentarum warehouse for the next 3 days, but afterwards, find your own logics, please. And he's gonna smile.
That's a slippery son of a bitch. say
everybody's
there. I say very well then. Maybe we can find a book around here or something that can give us some guidance.
Gazrim's gonna nod and say, "Not many libraries here in the Underdark," and he's gonna smile when he says that.
I'm sure you're not the only one that knows where this Graven Hollow is.
He's gonna look shocked and say, "I have no idea what you're talking about."
Oh, I'll get, like, when I said that first thing to him, I had the fucking, "Come on, man, like, look at my face."
he's gonna smile at you, Sidney.
By chance, are there any brothels here?
Oh, wait. I've got, hold on. Do you know how to play? God, what's it called? Empire. Then I'm gonna fucking flip it out like pieces set right out of my bag right in front of him.
Gazerb's gonna look at that and say, he's gonna say, "I'm sorry, Sidney, but this is all terribly droll. I don't know how much more assistance
I'm gonna I'm gonna look at it and put my hand droll. Do you have any idea what kind of empire board you're looking at right now?"
He's gonna cast gaze at it.
"I received this from one of the most powerful archmages I have ever seen in my life. This is not just pawns and rooks and knights. This is a collector's item. Almost priceless. And I'm willing to part with it if you can beat me in a game of Empire."
Almost priceless? Alright, Sidney, let's see a deception roll.
Okay. Oh god, I don't have fucking advantage. Boom!
Let's see.
Fucking rolling high tonight, holy shit.
Dude, I know. I'm gonna fucking nat one all through combat if we ever get into it.
Yeah, it'll happen.
Yeah, he's gonna see the board. He's gonna be a little, like, he's not going to believe you outright, you know, but you can see that he seems to soften up just a little bit.
I'll look at him. I was like, "I get tired of the, you know, traditional fighting and spending gold, you know, why not let it come down to a game of wits? You have this, you know, we play, I win, you maybe suddenly remember where Graven Hollow is, and I lose, and I lose my fancy chessboard."
Oh, Gazrim is going to, he's going to, like, shake, or he's going to say, fine. If you truly want to deal with it in a manner such, I will have Lorthun play in my stead."
"Okay. I'll pick up my board and I'll toss it in front of Lorthun."
I'll be like, "Sunny, I believe in you. Show him what you got, and I'll give you Bardic Inspiration."
Neat. Here's just a D6, right?
Yeah, just a D6.
Okay.
But you get to use it when you want to, for 10 minutes for it.
Well, this fucking guy probably has, like, 85 intelligence, so.
Oh, you're gonna compete intelligence. It's gonna be 3 rolls. And
advantage.
Advantage for what?
You gave it to me, remember? The second time I beat the guy that I played with originally, you said I'm proficient in it. Oh, I'm proficient.
Proficient, you don't have advantage, yeah.
Okay, that's fine. Okay.
No, it's your int plus your proficiency modifier.
Okay, so plus 3. Ability. Plus 3. Plus 3.
All right. Gonna go ahead and roll.
Oh, goodness.
Wow, 22. So he's going to roll once. So you ended up winning the first one. In the second one, Sinny, he noticed that 2 of the eyes are gleaming over you. You're going to have to make a DC 17 wisdom saving throw.
Oh, fuck
it. While you're playing.
Cheater. Wisdom save. Normal.
Oh,
get out of here.
So you notice that he was trying to read your thoughts to try to gain insight into what your next move is going to be, but you managed to resist it.
I notice it?
With a natural. We can say you notice it.
I'm like, hey, hey, hey. You got back at me. You got to shoot me with your big laser. Let's play fair.
I'm just going to smile, and then he's going to... Okay, then we can do the next roll.
Fucking good. Lord, this fucking place.
All right, he rolled a 23.
Oh, God.
So he won that one.
Oh, God. Oh, God, I'm fucking frightened. Checks my ass can't cash. Okay.
Alright, and then there's another roll. Let's see what you get.
Oh god, I'm gonna use my inspiration.
Okay.
Inspiration, D6.
It's gotta be... Oh my god, you tied with him.
Oh god.
Alright, we're gonna do one final tiebreaker, and you can see Lorthut becoming irritated.
Would I be able to tell, like, this is a very close game at this point?
Yeah, you'd be able to tell you. They're like, down to the final pieces.
I'm like, oh, Cinny, oh, this is intense. I bet you got this. And I'll give him again Bardic Inspiration if you're fine with that.
You can give him Bardic Inspiration, and as soon as you begin casting it, one of the eye rays casts Enervation Ray on you back. You're going to counter spell? Oh, no, actually, this isn't a cast.
He can't counter spell.
Yeah, so Cindy, or not Cindy, Mac, you need to make a DC 16 con saving throw.
Oh, okay.
He notices you casting the spell. Or, I guess, casting your feature.
Click on con saving.
Oh my god.
Oh, jeez. Hopefully I pass.
You take half. So you take, what is that, 19 damage? You take 19 necrotic damage.
Oh, okay.
He still got the spell off, though, didn't he?
We'll say that interrupted it as you were casting it.
Okay, alrighty. Oh, no!
And his roll was a natural 20, holy shit. 28.
Gee.
So he ends up winning, Lorthun ends up winning. And he's gonna look at Gosrim, and Gosrim is gonna like give a loud, obnoxious, and boisterous laugh, and he's gonna say, "Good show, Lorthun, you did it. I will be more than happy to add this to my collection of rare goods from the surface world."
I'm gonna visibly chuckle.
He's going to like cast a glance at you, and then snatch up the Empire set and put it in his pouch.
Sorry, I just thought of a funny joke.
He's gonna like shifty eyes you, and then he'll like walk back to his seat and say, "Well, that was some degree of fun, I suppose. But as you can see, Lorthun is more than capable at any task that you can throw his ways. Isn't that right, Lorthun?" And Lorthun's gonna roll his giant eye.
You said that, right? Can you shake my hand really quick?
I'm gonna look at Lorthun and be like, "Why do you put up with this guy? You look like you could have easily wiped the floor with everybody in that room. Why do you let this guy talk to you like that?"
Okay, one thing at a time. Mac, who did you ask to shake hands with?
Lorthun.
Lorthun's gonna look at you, and you're going to see a, like, scarred tentacle go to shake your hand.
Alright. Well, there goes my joke. Alrighty. Okay.
So Cindy, are you like saying that like out loud?
I'm gonna be like, "Why do you let Gazrim talk to you like that?" I'm not trying to be rude or anything, but I mean, from what we saw earlier, you're incredibly powerful. Like, what's going on here?
Well, and as soon as you say that, Gazrim is going to yell, "Because he's a member of the Zentarum, and the Zentarum do as they're told, Cini. Now, before you further antagonize any members of my enclave, I would appreciate your egress." And he's going to, like, sort of grind his teeth a little.
I'll look back at him and I'll be like, "Well, I have to be at your beck and call in order to be a part of the Zentarum. Maybe I'm backing the wrong horse."
I look over at Gazrim, and I say, "Gazrim, assuming that not many people know of, Graven Hollow. And assuming, just reach out and guess that maybe you do know. And since it's such a valuable kind of knowledge, I'm sure there's possibly something in Graven Hollow that could be retrieved as a reward for the information. And given that if we don't make it back, what have you lost?
So Gazrim is going to. So when you speak up, Bishop, you're going to notice that he's going to you're going to see just a little bit of like irritation in his he's going to flex his like jaw, you know, and like clench his jaw a little, and then he's going to say. Well, Bishop, there isn't exactly anything in Graven Hollow that would be capable of being taken had you any knowledge of the actual structure itself. It is the location and the information there within that is of value.
Oh, you do know about Graven Hollow.
So Gazrim is going to like look at you, Cindy, when you say that and say that I may have some semblance of an idea of how to obtain information to get to Graven Hollow, but that is not something, as I've been making painfully obvious, that I'm willing to let go cheap.
Oh, that's progress now. I mean, now we actually know that you know, maybe we'll be willing to spare a little coin. I wasn't just gonna throw gold at you for, you know, your mother's famous chocolate.
Alright, Greg is just gonna be fucking pissed off right now, and I'm gonna chuck 900 gold on the table. Can you just fucking tell us where this is already so I can leave this fucking town?
So, like, I am going to, like, grow really big when he sees 900 gold, like, just be put down. He
Hold
is
on,
going...
before I say I have 900 gold, let me check how much gold I have. Give me a quick second here. I know I have, like, a bit, but... Oh, okay, I'm dropping 800 gold, I'm sorry.
He's not amused.
800?
800 gold. 800, I'm sorry. I thought
that.
I had 900.
Gazrim will see that, and his eyes will go super wide for a very brief moment, and then he looks around and says, "For 1,000, my dear good man, you have a deal."
Now Tobu steps in front of him. Absolutely not.
Like he's gonna be grinding his teeth right now. Like. He'll probably see my hand, like, I'm clenching my pouch and, like, my veins are popping through my fists.
I'll give the 200 gold. Like, here you go, God.
So, Gazrim sees the total 1,000 gold, and you see, like, a big smile across his face as he grabs the 1,000, puts it into his bag of holding he's got, and you see him take out a ring. Or you see him, now that you notice, he's got a ring with a red gem, like, on the, like, emblade, what's it called? Like, into it, basically. So it's, like, made into the actual holder for it, so it's been, like, melted into it, essentially. And he's gonna pull out the ring, and he's gonna look to you, Bishop, and say, Bishop, on behalf of the Zentarum, I give you permission to use my ring to locate Graven Hollow. You'll know exactly how to use it when the time comes. It should lead you the way there. I expect you back in, say, 120 days, roughly, for return of this ring, if you don't mind. And he's gonna smile when he says that.
I will, I'll nod. And say 120 days it is.
So he says, excellent. And if you see this through, then there might be a promotion in it for you, my good man. And then he places the ring in your palm.
I say, I will forever climb the ranks of the Zentarum.
Oh, nods.
Got any mercenaries you could send to ensure the guaranteed return of this ring?
And to my best man. Oh, and as he says, he's like, sorry. My best humanoid, Lorthun. And Lorthun just once more rolls his eyes, becoming clearly irritated from all the social interaction.
Mac will blow out his smoke and look at Bishop and be like, oh, I just realized you're not human. Oh, jeez. Look at me. Looking past that. And I'll just keep on puffing my pipe.
Well, all right, where's the lodge? Grok is just going to... Grok is going to be like, where's an inn?
So Gosrum is going to say, you're more than welcome to stay at the barracks here. And he's going to point, I don't know if you guys can see that, but that building right that you're next to.
I am walking right to that building, not talking to anybody. Just right on in.
I'm gonna look at Lorthun before I leave, and I'm like, that was a good game, sincerely. I'm going to like try and be nice to him, because he looks like he's fucking like... There's like, you know, fucking blink twice if you're okay kind of thing.
So, Lorthun, he's going to just, like, look at you and he's going to, like, look at you and he's just going to respectfully, like, kind of nod or, like, bow his, you know, giant hulking mass at you.
I'm going to look at him as, like, I didn't know that beholders were such a... Oh, God, I can't think of the word. Had such a so low, small tank for social engagements.
I'm gonna look at, right before I look away real quick, I'm gonna, like, kind of in a whisper to Gazrim, like, hey, how much you want for that, board game?
The Empire?
Yeah.
He's gonna, like, pull it out, and he's gonna look at it, and he's gonna look at you, Judge, and say, let's say, between you and me, I know it's not priceless, but it's probably worth what? Maybe 100 gold? 150 gold?
Can I try to hear that?
Doing this, or are you? You're doing this like quietly, right, Joe?
Yeah, I'm gonna be like, okay. Like, all right. Honestly, I don't even think it's worth that much. I mean, I'll kick you down. I don't know, like 40 gold for it. Because I mean, I'm gonna be honest that. It's just a chessboard.
He's gonna look at it, and in a very like nervous laugh, he's gonna say, "I obviously knew that. That's yeah. 40 gold sounds more than fair, and of course." And he's gonna like kind of stammer as he hands you the chessboard.
Thanks, man. And I'm gonna walk away.
He's gonna wipe a bead of sweat off of his forehead as you
fucking, that was like full fucking the sweaty frog effect. Yeah.
I'm gonna wait till we round the corner and I'm gonna hand it to Cindy and be like, hey, left this.
I have no idea how much the fuck this thing is worth. It could be worth it.
Well, it's 40 now.
Oh, okay. I guess I'll have to ask Zoran next time I see him.
So yeah, over here, this is essentially just like, it's a barracks. It's not even like a, there's no like bar or tavern or anything like that here. Everybody kind of just keeps their own spirits. So you'll just see a bunch of cots in there. If you guys want to go in and rest or anything like that.
I'll call out to Gazrim and be like, oh, and the elephant in the room about that gem, you might want to throw an extra guard or two in front of the main door tonight. So it's a little wild out there right now.
Jim says, well, thank you so much for the information, but truth be told, I believe that if anything, the Zentarum will end up on top in this entire endeavor.
Hopefully you're more insightful about that than my chessboard, and I'll wink at him and walk away.
He's just gonna kind of like look to the side and turn red.
I'm gonna walk over to Bishop and use my pipe to ding across his legs to see if it like makes like a dinging sound or like a bone sound.
It's more of a dinging sound.
Dude, he's gonna appreciate that so much.
Oh, fascinating.
You're lucky, fascinating. Dude, you're lucky big boy's not here.
Right. And I'll just take another hit of my pipe and I'll just eye up and down, this up, and then I'm like, interesting. Jolly on walk over to the barracks.
Yeah, I'm gonna head in. I'm gonna take off my cloak and try and get the residual hyper beam off of it from Lorden.
So as you guys are doing that, Nevin is gonna walk in and he's gonna essentially say that he's sort of suspicious as to the Zentarim's, and he's gonna say this without not in judge's or bishop's presence. So he's gonna kind of just whisper to the internal crew that he's suspicious of the Zentarim's like lack of concern about this gem, and he's gonna he wishes to stay back and investigate the Zentarim further, and he said that he'll talk to Gazrim in the morning to try to work out some sort of deal to stay behind and make sure that everything is looked after appropriately.
I'll tell him that it shouldn't be too hard. He's pretty gullible. If I can trick him, it shouldn't be a problem for you.
Nevin's gonna laugh, and he's gonna say that just be sure to return to Mantel Dareth. We wouldn't want any Zentarim agents going after you lot. That ring that the Warforged has looks to be incredibly valuable.
I never want to return here.
I'm sure that nobody is going to try and murder us about it. It's going to be totally fine.
So he's going to nod and begin to, like, you know, sleep or make arrangements to go to sleep.
Are we going to be able to successfully long rest? Oh god, we ruined everything. I was adding my initiative, not my proficiency, so I would have beaten him by one on that last roll. Oh well.
Way to go.
Oh well. It's all over now. I was just looking. I was like, oh shit, proficiency's over there. I have 4 proficiency.
So, you all, unless you want to discuss anything, you all do successfully long rest for the night. But as you're long resting, Flink does come up to you, Cinny, and he says that from the sound of it, it sounds like you guys are leaving. And it doesn't sound like anyone really cares whether or not Yanta gets back the gem.
I'm gonna say to him, like,
it also sounds like that Osram guy doesn't care if more people die.
Yeah, he's definitely not the guy I would have chosen to stand behind this. But I don't know. We have I imagine we'll take a couple days before we take off to Graven Hollow. Maybe we can see if we can figure out. I mean, who, like, is this before we go to sleep?
Yeah, this is like when everyone's getting ready to go to, like, sleep.
I'm gonna tell them, it's like, you know, if you stick around with us for a while, you'll see that things kind of have a way of working themselves out. You know, we'll see what the town looks like when we wake up in the morning. This might I want to help you, and I have a feeling that this might be a problem we're not going to be able to avoid.
I'm gonna be looking at Cine filling up my pipe again and give him that, like, nod, like, you should break it to him a little bit more. And take a hit of my pipe.
I'm gonna... Is he still kind of, like, shaky and scared?
He kind of looks more worried now, especially after all the discussion. Like, he was right there in front of Gosrum, and Gosrum said that he's more than happy with having one of the factions end up getting killed off.
I'm gonna tell him.
Surprise! Like, he's worried. He's been living here this entire time. Isn't that the norm?
Do you say that, Grug?
I mean, I'm just saying because he seems worried. So I don't say that out loud because Grug doesn't give a shit about this kid.
Okay.
I'm gonna say just here, stay with us for the night so that I know you're safe. Keep that dagger close, and we can discuss it more in the morning. I will. We're not gonna, you know, just abandon you guys if, you know, it's gonna obliterate the whole town. Gazrim's, you know, I think thinks a little highly of himself. I don't think that this whole thing is gonna be as easy as he thinks it is.
Oh, Flink is gonna nod and then head to bed.
How like visually wise? Like,
is
how...
gonna cast four times good berries. I want 40 good berries on me.
Fuck yeah.
Okay. Yeah, 40 good berries.
Thank God. I'm gonna be fucking shoving good berries in my mouth.
Age wise, like flink to Yantha, like would I know like by just like.
Yeah, hey, Flink is definitely younger than he. Yantha's like middle aged, and Flink is like young adult, like almost teenager type of thing.
Okay, cool.
Like 18,
19,
kind of.
Yantha's his fucking MILF. All right, that's, Yantha's his MILF.
Flink is young, dumb, full of cum.
Oh, got it.
So.
I'm gonna fucking sleep with my socks on then. I don't want fucking.
So yeah, we'll say the night event ends uneventfully. You guys wake up in the barracks, which are like a bunk bed and everything like that. Not the most comfortable sleeping in lodgings, but at least it's not camping, and you end up sleeping on an actual feather bed for once. And yeah, it's the next day.
I check my sending stone to see if there's a message that I didn't get. I don't know how sending stones work fully.
Thumb bed.
Yeah.
Check your notifications.
He's looking for a voicemail.
Yeah.
Check your messages. No new messages. Just like sigh.
Just him messaging this one.
But
this
you
one
like phone. You fucking see him like posting on fucking Faerun book, and you're like, dude,
you see,
tell me what's going on.
You see how he's like, hey, anyone up late night? You're like, I am, and you see just it says red.
Oh, it's now offline.
Oh god,
it's just hey, I love you,
bitch. Oh, sorry, my cousin got my phone. Ha ha.
So, you check. You check the sending stone. What was the last message that you sent back? You remember?
I said something along the lines as like, I never really told you this, but I love you.
Yeah, it was when we were about to die.
Yeah.
So yeah, you're gonna get a reply back, and the reply back is just gonna be, what? Is everything okay?
Whoa, he can actually send through the Faerith. Wow.
Does he hear, they hear their voice, or do they just, like, hear, like, a Microsoft Sam?
You hear Justin from fucking, whatchamacallit, from the Twitch alerts, the little kid. Hi, my name's Justin.
I will say this, though. Like, halfway through the message, the message was continuing on, but it got cut during, essentially lost in space, whatever the fuck you want to call it.
Like for the famous.
Not the full message. Yeah, not the full message came, and it did come through kind of garbled or, you know, poor quality, but you did hear, what is everything okay? And then kind of, that's where it like cuts.
I'm gonna take Flink, and I'm gonna go try and find Gazrim. I wanna talk to him.
Okay. Well, you surmise that that's basically, this is Gazrim's, like, house and, or his quarters. So he's inside right now, clearly, while Lorthun is just menacingly standing, or, like, floating there.
I'm gonna approach Gazrim with Flink behind me, if he's gonna follow me.
Yeah, he'll follow.
And I say, sorry about, how things got a little tense yesterday, Gazrim, but, we've got a little fellow over here from the Deep Gnomes that is in some dire need of help. I think it might be in our interest to help out the Deep Gnomes.
Gazrim is gonna. You see that he initially greets you like jovially, and then he's gonna like look a little confused when you say that, and he's gonna say, "And in what way is?" In what way do they need help, and how would this assist us?
I'm going to say we discussed it a little bit yesterday with Jim we were talking about. If I had to guess, based on what's been going on around the town, the stone is either very powerful or very valuable. Either
way,
you're
gonna see like his eyebrows perk up when he's thinking for that, and he's gonna say, "Yes, I also was thinking that there's some value to this gem as well."
Said, "It was in Flink's possession. He lost it to a gargoyle, and then we found it on one of the drow." But
you're gonna see that Gosrim is gonna like laugh at Flink, like,
"Aw,
ha ha!" Like kind of laugh at him, and he's gonna say that you had the gem stolen by one of those stone bats in Mantle Dareth, and he's gonna say, "How clumsy could you possibly be?" And Flink is gonna look really dejectedly down at his feet.
I'm gonna look at Gazer and be like, "Hey, knock it off. He might be the only way we can get this gem back, okay?"
Gazer is gonna laugh and say that, "Oh, is that so? Well, let's send him out there so he could go and get it back from the drow then."
He's one of the only people we found that we know has been in contact with it and isn't acting super crazy. You saw the drow attack. You saw the gargoyle. When's the last time you saw a gargoyle madly in love with a drow? There's something inside or done with that crystal. And I think if Flink is able to maybe handle it without feeling the effects or something, I think, he's somebody we should keep around. You didn't see what happened at the drow. This drow was attacking her own people, trying to defend the gem.
So Gosrim is going to nod, and then he's going to say, "Well, truth be told, it's not completely unheard of for the drow to be infighting amongst each other. So that in itself isn't tremendous evidence. However, a gargoyle expressing love to a drow, on the other hand, that is a bit peculiar."
And when we saw Yantha, there is something wrong with her. Flink can probably testify to it, but she was just, it seemed like she really wanted to tell us something, but was just unable.
So Flink is going to sort of like look to the side when you say that, Cinny, and he's going to say that, "I don't know why, but Yantha really wanted the gem for herself."
I'm gonna look at him. I was like, "No, you have no reason to do this, but I've developed a bit of a soft spot for the Deep Gnomes in my travels, and I just, if you would able to help us out, maybe we'll be back from Graven Hollow in 110 days instead, might put a little bit more spring in our step."
So Gosrim is going to, he's going to say, "Well, Cinny, truth be told, I woke up in a bit of a good mood today. I woke up with a fatter wallet, noticeably fatter wallet than I went to sleep with last night, and that's enough for anyone really to wake up on the right side of the bed. So we could look into it. What do you propose?"
I think we just need to... Is there a way we can sneak in there from here? They're not going to let us back in. And the Dwergar and the Deep Gnome aren't going to be of any help right now. They're probably fighting back and forth still over that gym. I think if we were able to get in, let's see if we can track down the gym and get out. That would be the best.
No.
If we didn't have to resort to forts, but I mean, obviously that's not always how things work out.
Osram is going to say, "Cindy, I will be frank with you. There is no way that we will be able to enter the drow warehouse unseen. There are over 50 drow that live in the warehouse with at least 20 to 30 subservient quaggots enslaved by the drow, while the outside is constantly being monitored by the gargoyles, given obeying the call of what the drow say, and a host of at least 20 giant spiders constantly watching the top of the warehouse."
I'm gonna look down and be like, "Shit, I forgot about the gargoyles." Well, I mean, I'll be honest with you, I'm usually more brawn than brains. Do you have any suggestions for how we could get in there? I mean, if we have to kick in the door and steal it, so be it, but I'd like to prevent as much loss of life as we could. There's already been plenty of bloodshed. since we've been into town.
Gazrim says that it would be literal suicide to think that we could take on the drow. They have far, far more numbers than we do. They have more numbers than us three other factions combined.
How are they able to acquire so much more power? I thought everything was supposed to be perfectly balanced down here, for the most part.
It's perfectly balanced in the ways that we rely on each other for the flow of goods for Mantle Dareth, but it is the drow that provide all of the security for Mantle Dareth. And quite frankly, the Zhentarimar would manage all the trade from the surface world, while all of the gem expertise, prospecting, and enchanting that takes place happens by the Deep Gnomes, and the acquisitions of ores and materials and weaponry comes from the Dwargar.
I will say to him, so...
And he'll then say, truth be told, it's been quite peaceful here for quite some time. This is the most action that Mantle Dareth has had in... ever.
I'll say to him, well, we can't take them ourselves. What if we're, you know, both the Dwargar and the Deep Gnome are looking for the gem? You know, why don't we see if they'll help us? And, you know, maybe suddenly the gem disappears and nobody finds it. And I'll kind of look at him slyly.
He's going to, like, he's going to nod that he understands what you're saying. And then he's going to say, unfortunately, there's no, he says that the only way I can imagine the gem to be put on the table is through some act of diplomacy of some sort. He says that any mention of combat or infighting is just going to result in likely the entire collapse of this settlement.
Can you think of anything that the drow would want we could use as a bargaining chip?
So Gazrim is going to think about it for a moment.
I mean, you seem to have a lot of stuff down here. Certainly something must be valuable to the drow.
He's going to nod and he's going to say, truth be told, we had quite the deal set up at the meeting yesterday before it was interrupted. And then he's going to, like, kind of sigh and say that it may be possible to have another meeting with Cyrak to try to discuss the matters once more. And maybe we can bring up the gem during this discussion and see what we can discuss with him.
I think that would be best. What do you think if we were to offer to escort him and try and have the meeting in a neutral place? Because it just seemed like something was wrong with his guards. He obviously doesn't have control of them fully. If there's infighting is such a problem with the drow, he seemed to be, I wouldn't say trustworthy, but he didn't try to keep fighting or weasel his way out of it once he was caught.
He's going, so Gosrim's going to reply and say that I think that a most humble, and he's going to say that very particularly, humble approach might be what's needed to discuss with them, perhaps in the safety of their own warehouse, so that they can be completely certain that there is no funny business afoot.
Well,
and he's gonna look at you and he's gonna nod and say, I believe I may be able to give you an audience, but I would probably recommend your most diplomatic person speak before the group.
All right, let's do it.
So he's going to nod and he'll say that I'll send a word to get a meeting by noon.
I'll
let your companions know.
I'll pull out my torture chamber and offer him some and just say cheers then. Let's hope it goes well.
He'll nod and take some happily and say, quite frankly, it is a little early, but I can never say no to a good brand.
Man of culture as well, I see.
He toasts and enjoys it. So So basically, right now it's probably around like 9 o'clock in the morning, 10 o'clock-ish. So you guys got like 3 hours or so before the audience with the drow.
Okay, I'll approach the party and tell him, well, I've convinced him to get us another meeting with the drow leader, but the caveat will be that it has to be in their warehouse to make sure that there's no silliness about.
You don't got another one of those little fancy scrolls?
I hope we don't need that.
Yeah.
What our track record has been in this town so far, I think we're gonna need it.
He told us that he said emphasized having a humble approach, so we might have, as much as we don't like it, we might have to be a little kiss-assy. I think we get him this gem, you know. Maybe we can get ourselves a little bit more information or supplies when we go down to Graven Hollow.
Do you by chance know if the leader is a female? As I look at Judge.
He is
the leader
not.
Was the one
unless,
we talked to.
No, Cyrek was a man. Cyrek
unless
was a man.
Yeah, I'm
a
look at Mac.
Woman.
I'm gonna look at Mac. We talked to him yesterday.
I know. I'm just making sure. You guys are not getting my jokes. Okay, all right. I'll hold back a little bit.
Interestingly enough, though, Mac, that should be a particular thing of note for the group, knowing that typical
that is true. Typical drow hierarchy says have that women are usually in charge, so it's surprising that a man is in charge here.
That is interesting.
And also surprising that a woman was the one that was trying to attack the beholder.
This is the man cave.
I suppose. I mean, they've been busy trying to sort things out with her, so maybe they'll have gotten some information.
Yeah, what's the gem, or I'm gonna tell Mom.
I'm gonna eat. Is Bishop in the barracks with us?
Yes.
I'm gonna eat my rations. While eating my rations, I'm gonna hand some over to you, Bishop, and what you do.
I hold it, and I just stand there with it.
Like, oh. interesting. Okay.
Let me guess, you're gonna go back to your notebook when you see that?
Yep.
I'm gonna ask Flink, is there anywhere you know of where you could hide and be safe, or... If you can't think of anywhere where you'd be, you know, very safe, I think it would be in your best interest just to stay with us.
Flink is going to nod, and he's going to say that perhaps it would be best if I hang out with you.
Okay, well, this is the big show right here, so just make sure, keep your eyes open, don't get complacent. We're going into a very precarious spot this afternoon.
Flink nods and says that I'll. He says that no worries, I'll definitely find a place safe that I can hide.
If you can't fight, there's no shame in hiding to stay alive. I'll. And I guess I'll just. I'm gonna go see if Lorthen wants to play Empire while everybody else does other stuff.
All right, give me one sec.
I'll
obviously I'm a little rusty.
I'll say to Gruk, like, didn't know you had that much gold on you. That's a very surprising.
I'm not gonna respond back. I'm gonna look super annoyed at this entire ordeal that we just talked about.
Gruk's like, we got the ring, let's leave.
That's basically Gruk, where he's like, I got the thing we came for, why the fuck are we still here?
Okay, so I'll
look to Gruk. I'm assuming he's going to be pretty visibly agitated.
I am very visibly agitated.
Plays a round or two with you.
Say, I would say to him, doesn't this...
In the couple of matches that you play with
him and whisper, like, doesn't this...
You get the impression as Gosling's going in and out.
You guys
think
that would be...
So actually, like, talking
on our best interest
seems agitated, exactly being under the thumb of Gosrim, and you get the impression that he is sort of forced into this somehow.
Hello?
He is very specific and doesn't go into details about it.
I think I might have lagged out.
Oh, shit.
That was weird.
Yo, like, straight up, I see Muff was describing everything. Cindy was just going full blow into a description. I'm like,
mic check.
There.
Hello, hello. Alright, so C Muff and Cindy were talking at the same time for me, so you literally were talking over each other.
Okay, well, did you guys hear what I said?
No.
No, because Cindy kept saying, I want to go talk to Gruk. And I was like, okay, I'm waiting. I'm waiting, Cindy. And then it's just full chaos.
Okay, so Cindy, what I said was you end up playing one or two matches with Lorthun, and after the couple matches that you do play with him, you get the impression that he seems to be agitated being beneath Gosrim. Lorthun feels like he deserves to be in a higher position. But for some reason, he's sort of forced into the position that he's in, and he is being very adamant about not going into details as to why. But you do get the impression that he's not a fan of Gosrim in any way.
Well, I'll, are we alone? Sort of like, is there anybody around us, or can I talk to him, like, freely?
So Lorthun is being very specific and only communicating this type of thing when Gosrim is essentially, like, in his warehouse, and he's speaking very hushed tones.
I look at him and I was like, well, like, I understand you don't want to get into the details, but, I mean, just keep an eye out. I don't understand why a creature as powerful as you is being subservient to him, but I think,
keep an eye out.
You can leave if you want to.
So Gosrim kind of, or not Gosrim, Lothrin sort of shakes his head when you say that, and then he doesn't say another word about it.
I'm gonna leave the Empire set with him then. I'll tell him I'm gonna be back. I'll be back later.
What?
Forty gold to the beholder.
Yeah. If I can have a beholder that can think twice about the money I gave him, the gift I gave him, that's a win for me. Easily worth 40 gold to be anywhere near the good side of a beholder. Then, what I was saying to Gruk, this is, whole situation is dripping with Demon Lord. I think, don't you think it would be in our best interest to figure out what was going on before we dive into Graven Hollow, which is just Demon Lord history, probably hotspot town.
Grok is gonna look irritated and be like, and if it's not Demon Lord?
Then we leave and we go to Graven Hollow.
He's gonna look and be like, I don't think we're just gonna be able to leave, honestly. As much as I want to go and bother the drow, if he's saying what he's saying is true, I'm assuming you told us what he said, then I'll be like, then the drow control majority of this town, which makes it just another sort of drow stronghold with invitations of surface dwellers and others here because they need them.
Well, I don't know about y'all, but the Abyss Watchers having Mantle Dareth as an ally wouldn't be too bad either. Especially since we haven't really made a great impression so far.
I'll look to Gruk. I was like, if we're there, and it seems like, there's going to be fighting, or it's not going to go anywhere, we can just leave. But I think we'd be doing a disservice to ourselves if we didn't at least, go through with our meeting. That might not, we might already be in too deep with that. They might take offense to us not showing up or canceling.
I'm gonna be like, we have to go now. If we don't show up, then it's going to look bad for our. I'll look at Bishop when I say our host in this town. I'll kind of say host sort of sarcastically.
Yeah, I know. I mean, Ever since we left Tappy's, I just haven't had the same comfortable night's sleep. So I'm just
saying, with our track record here and how the Drow have operated so far with us, really kind of wish we had another one of those scrolls. Just saying.
My remaining 3 hours, I'm going to think about how foolish I was for never naming my staff the Thunderbonk.
And then I'm also, I guess before he does that, I'm also going to be like, since they have the gem, you know, they might become hostile with talking about it. So you might want to be prepared for that.
Ever since I left Waterdeep, I've just assumed that everybody wants to kill me. It's gone pretty well so far. Pretty consistently accurate.
Yeah, we're going to go in the lion's den with that one.
All right, so we'll say the time has passed.
Can I have Nevin's charisma modifier since he's not there?
Absolutely not. You have a couple charismatic people in your group.
Yeah.
I'm gonna... Oh, yeah, and that's Slattus. Slattus is just cool. He's like, fucking whatever. I'm a mantle Dareth.
Oh, yeah, dude. Slattus has just been chilling. He's like, it seems like to be in wonderment at this whole thing. Very enthralled at, you know, all of this, like, diplomacy and negotiation taking place and all of this stuff. He just seems to be genuinely curious about it.
I'm going to look to Flink and be like, if stuff gets sketchy, come find me, and I'll get you out of here.
He's gonna nod, and he's gonna clutch the dagger that's way too heavy for his little brittle arms.
The fucking little fucking kid with the crutches selling newspapers outside of the extra.
All right, so almost on cue, as your group approaches the gates, the doors open. And you're accompanied by two elite drow warriors, and they essentially escort you in.
Holy moly. Holy
moly. Oh my goodness. What the hell are those?
Those bullets?
Those are quaggots.
That's a big ass fucking quaggots.
Aren't those the lizards, though, from the outside that were dead?
There are, yeah.
This is going to be a lovely meeting.
So, the group enters, and you guys see Cyrak standing before you, and you see flanked at every position a bunch of drow. You look to your left and to your right, and you see that the warehouse is essentially covered in people enslaved by the drow, as well as elite drow warriors standing at the ready with their hands on the hilts of their weapon, ready to attack at a moment's notice.
I'm not going to have my hand anywhere near my quarterstaff. Let's see. So we were kind of rudely interrupted last time we spoke. We never really got to see what came of the agreement between you and Gazrim.
So, Cyrak is going to nod, and he's going to say, yes, it seems as though Kinyel decided to spring the attack at the most opportune moment when least expected. And then he's going to say that that poor fool... Her house hasn't been of any remote power in centuries in Mensa Baranza.
Have you spoken with her at all? Do you have any idea? I've figured out what her deal is?
He's gonna, just sort of, like, shake his head and say that she keeps babbling on about how killing Lorthun will somehow appease her house and bring honor back to her tarnished reputation of her house.
And am I safe to assume that the people of Menzo Branson don't give two shits whether or not she kills a beholder with only three tentacles?
Cyrak is going to nod. Yes, a maimed and weakened beholder such as Lorthun wouldn't be of any consequence to, quite frankly, anybody.
See, Sydney's going to, like, nervously look left to right. Make sure Lorthun's not like, oh, man.
And then he's, yeah, so then Cyrak is going to continue and say that, despite us telling her the obvious truths that her house is, her house hasn't been a valid house in Menzoberranzan for centuries, she seems to be attached to this idea that this simple act will restore them to their former glory. Every time we begin to tell her a truth, she seems to dig herself deeper in these insane webs of lies.
Have you had anyone in here, like, do you mind if we discuss the gem? That has to have something to do with this. We have Yantha's apprentice, gemsmith, here. Perhaps he can give us some insight as to why this gem is causing so much of a disturbance, because you can follow the path through Mantle Dareth, essentially. Everywhere it goes, there's chaos.
So Cyrak nods and says that, well, I'm not sure what that youngling will be able to ascertain. However, we had to put down that guard that held the gem earlier.
So, what do you think? Is there... Can we, like... Can you cast Scry on, like, an object? Or detect magic?
Was he being disobedient?
Cyrek nods and says that he created this fanciful story about how this gem was needed in order for him to express his family's long lost heritage and bring his father back to life.
Do you have it here? Can one of our... We have here... No funny business at all. We're curious. We want to know what's going on. May we see it and try to ascertain what its deal is.
He nods and he says, we have it under lock and key. And he shifts his gaze to, like, his left. And you see a little chest off to the side. Like a little coffer.
I'll look to him. No one else has physically touched it since it's been locked up, correct?
He nods his head.
Okay, so would you mind opening it so that our wizard here might take a gander at it with the detect magic? Judge SSM, nice.
Yes.
Okay.
So Cyrak is going to nod at the drow guard, and the guard's going to open up the coffer. And as soon as the coffer opens up, you all feel the gem essentially pulling your gaze towards it. You all want to stare into it. Its deep and haunting colors just seem to invite you into coming closer to it.
I'm going to grit my teeth when that happens and be like, I don't think we're going to need to touch it.
It's mine! Why shouldn't I have it?
I'm going to look at Jed like, all right. Don't touch it.
I'm gonna look at everybody and tell them that I'm gonna identify it instead. I'm pretty sure it has magic.
I'm gonna
So judge, you do know you will have to touch it to identify it.
We'll have to touch it to identify it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna hold my quarter staff over my head with two hands right behind Judge. Ready to knock him out if anything.
Oh yeah, I have to touch it. Let's see what I can do instead.
Judge, you gave me this Das Flute not too long ago. May I do something to maybe help you out?
Sure.
I don't know how this, if this consumes a spell slot for me, or if it's a charge for the Das Flute, but I'm gonna pull it. Alright, perfect, cool. Inventory. Well, I'll link the spell too. That I'm going to be casting. Don't know if it's going to actually have an effect on it. but that's the spell that I'm attempting to cast. And is it going to link Dust Flute? All right, there's the Dust Flute. I think it's charge base.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
That thing's so cool.
What is this?
This is that little flute that
we found from the Yeti long ass time ago.
Loot, my bad. My loot, yeah. That he gave to me when I was eating my pancakes back in the early days.
The good old pancake days.
Talking simpler times.
You hit the pipe less then.
It's so true. It's so true.
Okay, so is he able to cast
it? So yeah, you can cast it. You can cast Protection from Evil and Good.
Alright. I'll cast that on you. It's not the best song, because I'm not really used to this form of music or instrument, but I'll cast it and I'll touch you, and some like little white glow will shine across you and go inside your body, I guess.
I'm gonna keep my staff at the ready and be like, if anything happens, this isn't personal, Judge. This is business.
All right. So, do you attempt to identify it, Judge?
I'm gonna go ahead and preemptively use remove curse.
You're going to try to remove curse it, okay. Do you need a touch to do that?
I think so.
Oh no.
What?
I believe you need to touch.
Can you link remove curse?
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
touch. At your touch. So you're gonna have to touch it.
Either way.
Yeah.
Alright, if I have to touch it either way, I guess I'll just identify it.
Alright.
There we go.
So, the effects of Protection from Evil and Good are going to give you advantage on the saving throw.
Oh.
Oh boy. Alright. All right, let me pull up the list.
Oh God!
What else?
Let me just see.
The list. It's still like a fucking disguised deck of many things.
Okay, Judge, you need to make a DC. Is that what it is?
22.
It's a DC 23.
Close.
Saving throw with advantage against it is a charisma saving throw.
Oh, my worst.
Oh, hold on. No, I take it back. It's wisdom. This is not a spell that he's casting.
Close. Oh,
God.
Should have given you
only he had guidance.
All right. So you do end up identifying it for sure. But the effects of what exactly you're identifying will be known to only Joe in a second while I drag him to the other channel.
Oh no!
Alright, everybody get ready to get a fireball thrown at us.
Fuck, ready? Dude, I've got an attack ready. I'm gonna fucking knock him out. Oh my god!
Oh no.
And we're gonna have a fireball thrown at us.
Oh goodness. He should have DM rolled that one. Nah, it really wouldn't matter.
Oh, God. The sweaty frog is real. Oh, God. I don't particularly give two shits about fireball, so I'll take it, but.
I mean, I can count.
I'm sorry, Sinning. Many of us here don't have half damage or fire.
I can take no damage if I save to it. I automatically take, or if it's fire, I automatically take a quarter damage. But if I save, I don't take any. Oh god, this is taking a long time. So, based on Protection from Good and Evil, he can't be charmed, frightened, or possessed by the item, so it's none of those things.
He's getting cursed. Yeah. There's all reason why he's in the other room.
I know. Well, that's what I'm saying. It's like, based on the description of the spell, that's like the only thing it can be. It can't be charm, it can't be frighten, and it can't possess them.
Yeah.
So.
All right. So, Judge is identifying, and he's basically going to be describing this to you as he's identifying it for himself. So, as soon as he begins to cast Identify, a being of unimaginable power crosses and glazes over his peripherals and his vision. A being that he has never seen before. And his description is completely unknown to all of you. The image that he sees... Hold on.
Oh, God.
Oh, what the hell?
Fuck. Kill it with fire!
The artwork is not loading for it.
Oh, no.
Oh, come on! Let me know. Do you guys see anything if I do this?
No, I see.
No. It's just a little pops up, but there's no picture.
There's no picture. God damn it. Okay, let me re-import this.
Alright, let me Google this guy's name.
Right.
No, I'll import it for you. Give me one sec.
Yo-ho! This guy looks mean.
I closed it. Can you reopen it, Sima?
Yeah, hold on. I have to resend it to you guys. Dude, none of them are loading. What the hell? Okay, I'm just gonna fucking post it in Discord for you guys.
Only Judge sees this, or do we all see this thing?
Only Judge sees this. Sees it. But he's the one, he's giving you this description. Are you guys
ready? Oh, what the fuck
yep,
is
that's
that?
The same one I
oh
saw.
Oh my god.
Oh goodness.
So, as I was saying, this visage is what Judge sees completely cross his peripherals as he describes to you deep inside what this gem contains. As he identifies it, you notice that Judge is speaking and he's struggling to stay coherent in common as his voice like sounds demonic and fiendish as he continues with his description on what he sees. The entire essence of that being that Judge is describing, Judge can only describe it to you guys as being completely self-contained within that gem.
And half a gem.
If we break the gem, it breaks the prison.
Yeah.
Or he's a demon and he can't be here.
I mean, he's getting people to take him. What if he wants them to break it?
So you know that you know, Judge, that if needed, if wanted, you can contact the demon via telepathy.
Interesting. Okay.
Chat him up.
And I was wrong. It was a DC 23 charisma saving throw, not wisdom. So that would probably have been even lower anyways.
But I got different dice for my charisma rolls.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's see it, bro.
Here's a nat 20. Boom.
Yeah, you've already succumbed to the madness. We've gone far past that.
Whoa. What are you talking about?
When?
Let's see him, bro.
So.
It's gonna be like a 4.
While he's describing it, can I like try and like not necessarily like break the gem, but like knock it out of his hand?
Yeah, you can try to knock it out of his hand with your quarterstaff.
Okay, I'm gonna make an attack on him then.
Arm or, like the gem?
I'm just like his hand, or just like I'm just trying to like knock it out of his hands without.
Yeah, you can just hit Judge's hands to knock it out. But yeah, Judge is clutching it, by the way, as he's giving this description of it and everything like that. He's like clutching the black jewel, and as soon as like he finishes his description, I will say that Cini, you notice that Judge seems to just be kind of staring into the gem for a couple moments, and that's when you feel, if you would like, that's when you can feel that the need to sort of knock it out of his hand.
I'm gonna knock it out of his hand and be like, Judge, push it down.
So,
wait, are you gonna attack me?
I'm gonna try and knock it out of your hands. I'm not gonna like try and do damage to you, but like I can see his hands. Like I can see he's like clutching it really tightly. Like,
yeah, we'll say that.
Okay, because I know Judge relatively well, so it's like I would know that, you know, if he's acting really weird.
Okay, well you definitely know he's acting. Do you do that, Joe?
Yeah, if he's attacking, or he's trying to slap. He's trying to attack me.
All right.
Why are you trying to attack me, Cini?
You notice, Cini, that as soon as you like move your quarterstaff to try to knock it out, you notice Judge cast in reaction, and you bounce off of Judge's shield.
I didn't even have a chance to attack. As he glares at you.
Wait, go ahead, roll.
This tiefling is under hypnosis. Kill him.
Oh my god.
Your shield.
Holy
shit! Yeah.
Oh,
dude. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, shit. That just happened.
Yeah. That just happened.
Wow. All right. We'll say that with a natural 20, despite your shield, Judge, you're caught unawares by the quarterstaff, and you briefly drop it on the ground. You still maintain what you were thinking. You know, cognizantly and everything like that, so...
I'm gonna make him make a DC 15 con save, too.
Oh, gosh.
Oh!
It's done him. Another personal joke. I just... Nothing personal.
Betrayal!
Alright,
since... Steve's lost his mind!
Since Joe is stunned, he automatically fails strength checks, so I'm gonna restrain him. Alright, I'm gonna say, I have known this man for so long. This is not right. This gem, it needs to be decursed or destroyed or something. This is not okay.
Continue, never mind.
I'm gonna say, like, can I do, like, a history check of what would happen, like, about, like, gems containing demons? Like, was, like, is it... Is he still bound to his realm? Can I do like a history?
Little
like
boy?
Try. For sure, you can try.
Okay, I'm gonna do like.
You can look at Flink, and Flink seems to be completely flabbergasted by this one.
I feel like.
Fucking useless.
Well, I'm gonna do history, but I feel like. He can't just. It can't be that easy for him to be here. Okay.
Yeah, this is. You've never heard of a demon lord's, this is, again, a demon lord's presence being inside of a gem. This is literally the first instance that you have ever heard of this.
Okay, I'm gonna push everybody to the side. It's like, we need to think. Nobody touch this, nobody look at it. This is incredibly powerful stuff right here. So, what do? We can't touch it, and... We don't know what'll happen if we break it. I'll look to the drow leader. Any ideas?
Herak is gonna have his eyes completely open, and he's gonna just be completely in shock right now, and have no idea at all. He's actually gonna like take a step back from judging you. He's gonna then say that. You lot seem to be the expert here.
I'm gonna look at the party. I was like, I think we should break it.
I'm gonna try to attempt to pick it up with mage hand.
I don't think we should break it, in my opinion.
I do not think we should break it. If it is a prison and we break it, we're letting a demon lord out.
But if it's a prison, and like, he can't
just I'm gonna look back
be in this realm.
And I'm be like,
if we break it, then we get to fight him.
Yeah.
So I'm for it.
There's a lot of value here. They'd be doing a lot of the legwork.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm gonna look at Cinny, and then be like, little Ahomba, your friend there apparently wasn't affected by it. No.
Well,
this is true.
Yeah, but I mean, look at this. I mean, what better time? What better time?
If he wasn't affected by it, don't you think that is a little suspicious, seeing how Judge was quite quick to the gun there?
I mean, it's possible, but we've all succumbed to, you know, various dark magics in the time we've been down here. It's, you know, just because we all know Judge is powerful, that doesn't necessarily mean he's immune, especially if it's the magic of a demon lord.
So
I'm just
surprised
that he didn't break it.
So on that note, Cinny, it is like literally the essence of the demon lord, not just magic of the demon lord. This isn't like his item; it is him inside of the gem.
I'm gonna look to the party. Like, what better time? We have a full army of drow. We have the Abyss Watchers. We have. Worst case, he comes alive. He wouldn't stand a chance. He'd be completely overwhelmed.
I'm gonna look at Cindy and like, have you forgotten what happened with Zuktar and what's the other place we were at? Have you forgotten what happened in the Neverlight Grove and also Sloopledop? I mean,
no,
even
not at all,
even in Blinkenstone, we fought a servant of the Pudding King. We fought the Pudding King, who's a servant of where the fuck is his name? Wait, we don't have. Oh no, it's under Demon Lords. Excuse me. Okay. Jublex.
You're about to see the chaotic of my chaotic neutral go on. I'm gonna swing at the gem and try and break it.
I picked it up with Mage Hand.
Okay.
A while back ago, while you were talking, and have it like in front of me. Am I able to hold this object of 10 pounds, is it, or is it more?
You can have it float. That's fine.
Okay.
I'm gonna take a swing at it. I'm gonna try and shatter it.
Alright, well. How does the attack against my Mage Hand, would you say?
It's just gonna be the AC of the gem.
Gem has an AC?
It's an AC of 10.
I hit it.
Alright, Cindy. You swing at the gem and your quarterstaff is not magical.
It is.
Is it magical?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All my attacks are magical.
Oh, that's right.
He imbued it.
Dealing enough damage to shatter it as it falls to the ground, you see that the essence of the, like, a visage of Fraz Erblu comes up, and just as that happens, like, all of the demonic energy completely darkens the entire room that you guys are in right now with a inhumane, fiendish darkness that, despite any of you that have dark vision, begin to have difficulty seeing. And you hear, what was that?
I have double sight. I can see in magical darkness.
This is not magical darkness, believe it or not.
Aww.
Yeah. Okay. this is different. Like I said, all the lights go out in the room. You hear a scream of anguish and pain coming out from Fraz Erblu, and light returns, and Judge is feeling a lot better.
Ooh, what a coin flip! Oh God.
But,
I'm gonna play off totally confident, but like, see, I told you guys.
You put a lot of us in danger just to be so feisty with that. I thought you were more of wits. Am I wrong here? Like, was that not too quick on the thumb?
I mean, Grok is gonna, like, I want to say back up Cinny, but he's gonna be like, I mean, it was the right play, but I'm more concerned now with how this gem got about. Because, quite frankly, if people have been touching this gem and they've been either being lied to or have a deception of, as Sarika says, the two of these folks wanted their dead father alive, they wanted to bring honor to their house, who hasn't seen their house in an honorable stance in millenniums, then clearly this gem is seeping lies into their heads, which I'll look back to Flink, I'm like, he was probably lied to, saying that if he kept the gem, what's her name will love him.
I'm gonna, like, we noticed that Judge is back to normal, right?
I'm gonna say, you, really loudly, I'm gonna point at Flink, so I'm just gonna walk over to Flink and be like, what the hell are you people doing with an item like that?
Flink gonna look around and say that, it was the dwarves,
remember? They're the ones that wanted their gem back.
Oh.
So, I mean, like, it just, like, there's no residual, like, demon lord energy floating around.
No, in fact, as soon as the light, like, returns to the room, the gem that is shattered on the ground begins to turn to ash.
I'm gonna, okay, well, if Judge is feeling better, he's obviously a little irritated, but certainly that must mean that anybody else that was affected by this must be. Did they kill what's her name, or is she still in prison?
I was like, Syrac, can you pull out what's her name, the girl, if whatever her name is, to see if she's still alive?
Syrac is going to nod, and he's going to go into the barracks behind, and he's going to pull her out, and as she's bound, he's going to basically come out and throw her on the ground, and he's going to look at her. And she's just going to, like, keep her head down in dismay.
All things considered, how do you feel? I'm assuming she's not gagged or anything.
No, she's not gagged.
I'll look at her and be like, do you feel like your house is still not in an honorable stance? And do you know that your house hasn't been in an honorable stance?
She just kind of looks to her side and says, why does it matter? I'm a dead woman now.
Not necessarily. We're doing some investigating right now. Like, I'm gonna put my quarterstaff on my back.
So Kinyal replies back and says that it doesn't matter how I feel. Syrac will have my head.
I'll look to Syrac.
Syrac will step up and say, once this business is concluded, you're absolutely right, I'll have your head.
Let's say, hey man, you saw what happened, to our guy. If she was under the influence of the gem, there's nothing she could have done. I'm not trying to tell you how to run your city, but I mean...
The drow have no place for those weak-minded enough to fall prey to the whisperings of demonic energies.
Hey.
I mean... We're not talking about, like, a little freaking spooky imp flying around. This is a full-fledged demon lord.
Well, we can't have...
Your grandpa's demonic energy.
Yeah.
We can't have monkeys running around with guns now, can we?
Yeah.
Or should I say Quaggis running around with explosives?
Can I try and, like, roll to persuade him? Like, convince him...
You can roll. I'm gonna make the DC like DC 24. It's gonna be pretty hard.
It's gonna be really hard.
Okay, so I need Bardic Inspiration to make it mathematically possible.
I'm just looking at you, still displeased.
Okay, nat 20 or nothing. Booyakash.
You're for nothing.
That's your choice. I'm not a drow. I don't know much about your culture. I guess if that's how it's supposed to be, it's how it's supposed to be, but I think you're making a mistake for what it's worth.
Tyrak, kind of looks irritated at you, Cinny, and say that Listen, while I appreciate you dealing with this matter, let's not let the patients go untested. You've solved this matter. We can resume business in Mantle Dareth now.
Yup, and I'm going to start walking out.
Say, well, fair enough. I guess we got to go tell Gazrim the bad news.
So, first off, you all get 1,000 XP for destroying Frazer Blue's gem.
Woo!
Woo! Wouldn't he be happy since now the deal's gonna go through?
Oh yeah, however, he's definitely happy.
Yeah, however, I do feel like the Deepgnomes and the Wargar aren't going to be fighting as much. Listen.
I think if we can convince enough people of the truth that was really at hand here, I think we can at least convince the Dwargar and the Deep Gnome to stop fighting.
It was the madness of the gems that made us fight, you crazy Dwargar. Come on. You think we would actually fight you like that? We're clearly influenced by this magical item.
We're going to need a deception roll for that, Judge.
I mean, if that's what we want to say, I'll say it. I could probably word it properly.
As we're leaving, I'll look down to the what's her name and say, "Well, I'm sorry. There's nothing more I could do for you. I tried my best. At least I hope that you can find peace in the afterlife."
I'll give you inspiration for that, Zinni.
Wow, oh. Such a chaotic neutral person caring about somebody else.
Chaotic, that's for sure. Because he hates Drow normally, and he just was nice. There's no rhyme or reason there.
Oh, she's a drow, but she was being mind controlled and she had no control over what she's doing. So it's like, you know, she basically committed a crime that she had no control. She's like a werewolf. You know, she fucking got up, she ate an orphanage and woke up covered in blood.
I'm going to look at Cyrak and be like, "You made a powerful friend today." And I'm going to walk away.
Is there a mark inspiration on this one? There it is. I see it. That's right there. Blind. Yeah. Well, let's go to Gazrim then. Maybe we can get that.
While we're walking over, I'm going to pull out my notepad and we look at Bishop like, "So, what did you dream about last night?"
I dream. What do you mean, dream?
Oh, interesting. And I scribble down in my notebook.
I'm going to look to flank and be like, "Until we kind of get our story straight, I think you should stay with us. You shouldn't be out by yourself until we kind of start explaining what's happened to the other factions."
Flink nods. As you guys are leaving, you hear a blood-curdling happen from what you can surmise as Kim Yell's throat being slit.
Oh! Like, oh!
Music to my ears.
I wince a little bit, kind of frown, but there's nothing more we could do for her.
Some women just want to see the world burn.
Cindy's gonna roll his eyes into the abyss. Say, let me try it this time. Hey, open up.
You're met with silence.
Crickets.
Okay, I'm gonna roll with deception, and I'm gonna try and sound like Bishop. open up.
I'm offended.
You're just testing your security.
All in good fun.
I'll say it's not like that. It's more like this, as I attempt to say it like him.
I kind of pick him up and hold him so he's like, if he's knocking down at like ankle level, they're not gonna buy it.
What would, if I am to roll, what would I roll for this?
This would be deception for sure.
Alright. 24.
Woo! Fucking
nope. I'm completely fine if it doesn't work. I just
24 to sound like Bishop. Alright, you'll get like a you'll like see.
Just have him open the flat.
Like the little window opens.
Yeah, exactly. The window opens. Yeah, the window opens instead, and they're like, "Bishop?"
They see me like holding
my hand. And the guys like then the guard like looks and then he like looks to the side and sees Bishop and says, "Oh, there you are," and then opens the gate.
I'll look at Mac. Oh, like, that totally worked.
Die.
Expect a thing.
Next time, I should probably disguise myself next time. We'll wear like a charm.
Yeah,
rev up those fryers.
We need to find a find a robe that can fit around both of us, so we can just pretend to be one really tall person.
Oh, I like that. That sounds good.
Go see an R-rated movie.
That's how I was able to sneak into a play once.
I'll approach Gas Room, I guess, unless anybody else wants to talk to him.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay. Like, so, Gazrum, the gem was actually the contained soul of a demon lord, and we broke it, and everything's fine now. That's just the cliff notes, but...
Gazrum is gonna look stunned at you, and we will continue the session next week. This is where we will end tonight's session. So we end it right as Cinny tells Gazrum that the gem that had imprisoned Frazer Blue had been shattered.
Dude, I was waiting like all week. I was like thinking, I was like, as soon as we get that fucking gem, I'm gonna break it. That's it. I've been thinking about it all week.
The balls on you. Dude, that could have backfired so hard.
Dude, favors the brain.
It may still backfire, you know.
True.
It's
fine.
Y'all think it's over.
It's true. Demon lords just don't go bye-bye like that.
Yeah, they don't go bye-bye by breaking a crystal.
Either way, it's clear that the magical energies emanating from the crystal are no longer affecting this area, so...
Like, we saved the city, Patrick, but, you know, like, the amount
cost?
Of damage... yeah, what cost?
It's like he just spawns in Waterdeep.
Yeah.
No, like, literally, we walk outside of the city, he's right in the Dark Lake, like, ha-ha!
But I was totally, like, that was 100% like, let's see how much this is going to be like, wow. Like, demon dies, it goes to the fucking, what's it called? Wherever the Burning Legion is.
It's like, Outland?
No, like, what's the plane called where demons go when they die and then they just have to wait to be resurrected?
It's kind of like Oblivion.